Okay, more negative feedback. This is part four of your endocrine system video series, you lucky dogs. All right, anyway, again, negative feedback. I don't want to get real hung up in this particular one, but I do want you to know what ADH does. So that's where we're going to go. This is dealing with blood osmolarity. All blood osmolarity means is how high concentration of solute do you have in your blood? Okay, and that's gonna, as you remember, the water follows the solute. So wherever there's lots of solute, that's where the water is gonna tend to go. And so depending on different situations, we want to be able to manipulate where the water goes in your body, and so we want to be able to manipulate where the solutes go in your body. So, if your blood osmolarity, you have a lot of solute in your blood, okay, receptors will be stimulated, and again, these would be nervous ones, but then stimulate the pituitary. We'll talk about this in a minute, but this is the hormone I want you to see, ADH. This stands for anti-diuretic hormone. Now, if anybody has ever had a family member or whatever, if you've heard of a diuretic, it is a medication that a person would take if they had a lot of fluid retention, perhaps fluid in their legs, it's making their legs swell or something like that. So a diuretic would make your body get rid of that excess fluid, and normally you just pee that excess fluid out. Anti-diuretic means you're gonna try to pee less. You're going to try to retain water. You're gonna try not to lose it. So this hormone tries to retain water in your body. So if your body senses that you are losing water because it's measuring your blood osmolarity, how concentrated the solution is in your blood, then anti-diuretic hormone will be released and cause more water to be reabsorbed by your body, and you will pee less because your body is going to reabsorb more water and also increase your thirst. You're going to feel thirsty because your body is sensing that you are have lost too much water for whatever reason, and so you will retain water and increase your thirst to try to compensate for that. Now, if by the opposite relationship, your blood osmolarity drops too low, there's too low a concentration of solutes, meaning there's more water in your blood, then a different location is going to be set to release some different hormones. And I really, renin and angiotensinogen or whatever, these are not things that I've ever really seen on a test. But the bottom line is there is a system to in to bring that blood osmolarity back up. I think really the thing you need to take away is this ADH and what its role is. Okay? Again, negative feedback. Now, let's focus on, we've been kind of testing the waters with some of these words, hypothalamus. We need to talk about the endocrine and the nervous systems are linked together. Okay? The nervous system, we're talking brain, spinal cord, nerves, neurons. The endocrine system, we're talking glands. The hypothalamus is the link that connects those two. It is a nerve part of the brain. The hypothalamus is part of the brain. And if you look at this diagram right down here, I'm going to move the cursor over here. The hypothalamus, that is part of the brain. That is right there. That's part of this brain tissue. But hanging off of that is an endocrine gland. This kind of paired grape-like things, in fact, they're much smaller than that. I think they're usually said to be about pea size. This is the pituitary gland. It's one gland, but it has two parts. Okay? So, again, hypothalamus nervous system. Okay? It is getting nerve signals from around the body sent to it. Now, it communicates with the endocrine system by producing things called releasing hormones. And what it does is it will send releasing hormones to the pituitary to tell the pituitary to release hormones into the body. Now, the pituitary gland is often referred to as the master gland, okay, of the endocrine system. The hypothalamus is not a gland, but it is what is telling the pituitary gland what to do. So it's really the big cheese, but it's not part of the endocrine system properly. It is a nervous organ. The pituitary gland is the master of the endocrine system part. It's the one that's going to be telling the rest of the endocrine system essentially what to do. Okay? So it in turn, when it gets the signals, those releasing hormones from the hypothalamus, it will secrete a broad range of what are called tropic hormones. And all this means, tropic hormones are hormones that tell other glands in the body what to do. So the anterior pituitary, the pituitary gland will secrete hormones that tell other glands when to secrete their hormones and when to do what they need to do. So this is a diagram illustrating, there's your brain, your hypothalamus. It is connected to the pituitary. This is the anterior pituitary. This would be the half of the pituitary gland that is pointed towards your face from the inside of your head. So your face would be over here looking to the left. This is the back of your head over here pointing to the right. And so that's how it ranges if you were looking at your head in profile. Now, the anterior pituitary will release tropic hormones, stimulating hormones, okay? It will release thyroid stimulating hormone, which will activate the thyroid gland to do something. This is something that I don't think you're ever going to see, this ACTH hormone. I wouldn't sweat worrying about that right now. Growth hormone, you might just want to remember GH, but that would stimulate, obviously, bone and muscle growth and so on. Now, this one's pretty important. The gonadotropic hormones, meaning they affect the gonads, meaning both testes and ovaries are stimulated by follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. We always think of these two as associated with women, but they're not. They are also associated with men. These are the things that are secreted from the pituitary that tell these sex organs, hey, get busy and do what you need to do. Okay? Prolactin is the hormone from the anterior pituitary that tells the mammary glands that it's time to begin milk production. That's not the only thing prolactin does in vertebrates, but that's what it does in us. Okay. And melanocyte-stimulating hormone, I wouldn't sweat that one too much. Now, the posterior pituitary, the back half of the pituitary gland, is dealing with a couple of different hormones. These don't have that SH deal with them like a lot of these others, this FSH and TSH and all that. Oxytocin is what is going to be stimulating contractions to occur during labor, and so it affects only the muscles of the uterus, and there's your ADH hormone, the antidiuretic hormone that would make you retain water if you're